35% of Americans missed routine cancer screenings because of COVID-19. As a result of delayed screenings and delayed physician appointments, the U.S. saw a combined 46% decrease in diagnosis of certain cancers. Missed screenings and treatments could result in 10,000 deaths from breast and colorectal cancer. Here's what you need to know about screening, prevention, and care when it comes to COVID-19 and cancer-affecting women from the team of experts at the Sarah Cannon Cancer Hospital at Medical City Plano.
Welcome. I'm Melissa Threlkeld, Regional Vice President for the Sarah Cannon Cancer Institute at Medical City Healthcare. Thank you guys for coming. Dr. Nguyen, have you or any of your colleagues seen any patients who have postponed their screening mammograms and as a result had a delay in diagnoses?
Yes, we have. And it usually comes in three scenarios. The first scenarios are the patients that we saw back in March for their regular yearly routine checkup. And these are the patients we read the mammograms and we saw some concerning findings and we request for them to return for additional evaluation. Normally they would come back within 1 or 2 weeks, but with the COVID, then they put it off and they don't come back at all. So that's scenario one. Scenario two would be the patient well actually came back and we did the extra workup and recommend a biopsy for a concerning finding. But again, due to the COVID for various reasons, they don't come back for the needle biopsy. And we start seeing them again come back either 3 months later or even to now to do the biopsy. And by then, you can see the tumor or the lesions got bigger compared to what we saw back in March. So, and then the last scenario is where patients are due for their yearly mammogram in March or April, but didn't come in because of the COVID. And are now just coming in for us to check it now. So we see lesions now that, again, it's hard to say what was it back there and back in March or April. It's hard to say that. But you can make an assumption that had they come in for their checkup in March and April, we probably would have found the lesion much smaller.
Safety is obviously a concern for any patient who enters a healthcare facility during COVID-19. What is Solis Mammography, Medical City Healthcare's imaging partner, doing to ensure the safety of patients who visit for screening or diagnostic procedures?
The way we do that is that we screen our patients at the front door. We take their temperature, we ask the pertinent questions, and if they pass, then they move on to for their mammogram. In the waiting room, we block out, in the seats where they can be 6 feet apart, sitting in a waiting area. And when they check in with the front desk, same thing, we put markings on the floor that's 6 feet apart. So we're taking precaution in that. And every patient that enters our office requires to wear a mask.
Dr. Anglin, what would you say to a patient who has symptoms, for example, a lump in the breast, who's worried about visiting a physician's office or a hospital to receive treatment during this time?
I would say that physicians' offices and hospitals are potentially safer than other places you could go. In my office in particular, we've separated how we see our patients so that I'm seeing patients on one day and my nurses are doing easy follow-up on another day so that we're limiting the number of people in the waiting room. We're doing the usual screening with questionnaire, temperature checks. I get my temperature checked every time I walk in the office. Masking, face shields with our visits. So we're really taking precautions to make it safe.
Before we leave this topic, would you please remind everyone when someone should see a breast surgeon?
If you feel a lump, you should definitely see a breast surgeon. Nipple discharge, that's another indication. If you have any abnormalities in the visual appearance of your breast, if the nipple's changed, if there's inversion in the nipple, if there's skin dimpling, you need to see a breast surgeon to help figure out what's the next plan. A lot of times it's imaging. Sometimes your mammogram's first and there's an abnormality that then you come see the breast surgeon afterwards. And I'd like to mention that genetics, a strong family history of breast cancer, ovarian cancer, pancreatic cancer, those can be indications for genetic risk for breast cancer. In those scenarios, those are times you should really pay attention to your breast health.
Would you please remind the women in the audience when they should start screening for breast cancers?
Women should start being taught breast self-exam in their teens. Women should start seeing a physician yearly for breast exam, starting at 20 until 40 when their mammograms start. And that usually can coincide with their well woman exam, mammogram, physical exam by the physician, and imaging.
Dr. Heffernan, screening for gynecologic cancers is just as important as screening for breast cancers. When it comes to cervical cancer specifically, what impact does waiting 3 to 6 months for a cervical cancer screening have?
The guidelines on how we screen for cervical cancer have evolved tremendously over the last 15 or 20 years. And that really has largely to do with the fact that we're collecting more and more data. Millions and millions of women are getting pap smears. And as a result, our data set has grown and we've been able to understand better just how often we really need to screen people. As a result of that, the screening guidelines where historically a woman would get a pap smear every year indefinitely, essentially from puberty onwards, has changed quite a bit. And the guidelines now recommend pap smears being performed anywhere from every 3 to every 5 years, depending on the guideline and the age of the patient. So with that in mind, waiting for 3 to 6 months is not a terribly long time to wait for a pap smear.
What would you say to patients who are nervous about coming to the hospital for surgical interventions?
In the operating room here, for example, COVID testing is done 48 hours before procedures. And we get those results and are able to screen the patients very accurately before the procedure begins. There are patients who need surgery while they're actively testing positive for COVID, and that happens. And it's not ideal, but it can be done and is done. And the hospitals and surgeons and physicians and nurses have figured out how to do that and do it safely.
Before we leave this topic, would you please remind us how often a woman should be screened for gynecologic cancers?
Sure. Well, the main screening test that we have for a gynecologic cancer is the pap smear, screening for cervical cancer. For age 21 to 30, it's a pap smear by itself every 3 years. The current guideline for age 30 to 64 is a pap smear plus HPV testing every 5 years. And after age 65 or after hysterectomy, no pap smears are necessary. That's a pretty new change to the guideline, and it's certainly not what most gynecologists grew up doing. It's also not what most patients grew up doing. And so there's a little bit of anxiety on both sides of that equation. Many, many patients will get pap smears more frequently. I don't think that there's anything wrong with that, but the guidelines have actually spaced the pap smear out quite significantly over the past few years. The other elements of screening for things like ovarian cancer and endometrial cancer, we don't have specific tests or blood work that screens for those, but the most important element there, both for this cancer and really most other diagnoses, is communication. Patients really do need to see their physician once a year for their annual examination, well woman exam. And it's in the course of that conversation and examination that problems are frequently caught early. So that truly is the most important element, is communicating and having your physical exam once a year.
Thank you so much. Thank you for answering some important questions and helping educate the community about the impact of COVID-19 on women's cancers.
If you have additional questions, call our 24/7 hotline, Ask Sarah, at 972-202-8877 to speak with a nurse, or visit us at asksarah@sarahcannon.com to submit any questions.